Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I want to talk to you about the eyeshadow palette tag, and I'll link the two YouTubers that started it below. And let's get started. So your newest eyeshadow palette. So my newest eyeshadow palette is the Pat McGrath Divine Rose 2. I haven't received yet, but it will be included in the giveaway, so make sure you're subscribed. I'll link the details down below how you can enter. Number two, what's your oldest palette? So my oldest palette is actually the Urban Decay Alice Through the Looking Glass palette. And I love this palette. I remember I picked it up at Ulta for the first time and I fell in love with the packaging. I didn't get to use it as much, but it definitely takes me back to a time where things were more, you know, creative with palettes and packaging was still bulky and we didn't mind. Also, I think it retailed for like something close to $50 or $60, and I was just so excited to watch several tutorials. Even though, like I said, I didn't get to use it as much, it was just, you know, a good time for it, you know, with the movie coming out at the same time. A little drawer inside it and a little nice butterfly detailing on the top. And overall, I will say that I was pretty happy with the purchase and I will not be getting rid of it or decluttering it anytime soon, even though it was like super bulky. So next is most expensive palette in your collection. So my most expensive palette has got to be either Natasha Denona or Pat McGrath, but I depotted my favorite Natasha Denona pans, and what I came up with instead of a 15 pan or a 24 pan was an actual 30 pan Natasha Denona palette of my own, and it included the Sunset palette, the Bebo palette, the Gold palette, and several shimmers from her mini. So this actually is my most expensive palette, and it does actually include some from her 24 pan eyeshadow palette. And I actually like having them all in one place here as opposed to having them inside those pans. So yeah, this is actually my favorite. So the next question is, what is the most affordable palette in your collection? Now I could go on and talk about several $3 e.l.f. palettes, or I can talk about multiple cheap ones, but I have to say that the cheapest palette that I actually have is a free palette from Ulta Beauty. It came as a gift with purchase, and they do gift with purchases all the time. So yeah, that's my most affordable palette. Next is an everyday palette in your collection. So I don't know what you would classify as an everyday palette, maybe like a neutral palette, something that you could wear whether it's going to work or to go out to a night out. And I think that, for example, this Dominic Cosmetics Rustic palette has a combination of both. It has some nice neutrals for day wear and it has some nice shimmers for a nighttime wear. But if we're talking about strictly every day and we're not talking about having anything for like night looks, which this does, I would probably go with something else, like something neutral, like the Tarte B palette or the Urban Decay Naked Reloaded, which is one of my favorite Urban Decay palettes because it has the nice peachy tones and the brown tones, and or also the Tartlet in Bloom, which came out like a couple years ago, and I still think that's a really good everyday palette. Both of these are my favorite everyday palettes because the formula is just so smooth and I really enjoy, you know, the shade range on both of them. So I think those are my favorite. So most colorful palette in your collection. So as far as most colorful, there's quite a few. There's the James Charles palette, which I have, which is very colorful. But when I think of most colorful palette, I also think of like which has the most shade range and bright colors and maybe some neon colors even. So definitely from anything from the Norvina collection, especially the ABH Norvina Volume 2 palette, has got to be the most colorful palette that I own because it just, the shades are so bright and definitely out there. Compared to the James Charles palette, I find that these are almost like neon. They don't show up necessarily neon, but they are neon looking in the pan. And so the next question is the smallest palette you have in your collection. Now, a lot of people have been showing their Natasha Denona mini palettes, and of those, my favorite Natasha Denona mini palette has got to be the new retro palette. But if I'm going with the smallest, it's got to be the Kevin Aucoin duo contour palette, and this is definitely still an eyeshadow palette. It was used on me as an eyeshadow palette when I went to a fashion show. And so the next question is the biggest palette that you have in your collection. For me, the biggest palette has still got to be the James Charles Morphe palette that came out, I think, in like late 2018. Best memory palette, going back to this fashion show that I was talking about in New York, I got the Kevin Aucoin Contour palette and the Volume 1 book, which is one of my favorite eyeshadow palettes and contour palettes combined, and have a really nice memory of that. So next is worth the hype palette in your collection. I say the most worthy of hype palette has got to be any of the Hourglass Ambient palettes, and you can't go wrong with those. They're definitely worth every penny. But since we're strictly talking eyeshadows, and these can be used for blushes as well, I don't know if I should include them in this category. I would say one of the Pat McGraths, like for example, the mini Star Wars palette. This was one of my favorite palettes, and I think it was worth the hype when it came out. I wasn't able to actually get it when it launched, so I had to go buy it from a third party, but it was worth it. And if you're going with like truly worth the hype, I would say the Master palette by Mario, which was the very limited edition ABH palette, and that palette was truly worth the hype. And for whatever reason, I don't know why it hasn't been re-released yet, but I managed to get two of those and gave one away, and so I still love the one that I have, and I'd say that palette was definitely worth the hype, and it was, hopefully they bring it back. So we'll see. Not worth the hype palette in your collection. So there's quite a few palettes that I always talk about that are not worth the hype, but if I'm going with one palette in particular that was definitely not worth the hype, I would go with, you know, any of these Too Faced scented palettes, like the Papaya palette, or I have palettes that are worse than that, actually. I'd say the Millennial Pinks palette from Melt Cosmetics was probably not worth the hype. A lot of people didn't like it. I didn't like it, and I thought that it was very hyped up, but there's a few pinks that I still managed to get some good looks out of, so I'd still say there are palettes that are more unworthy of the hype than this palette for sure. So yeah, while this one was not worth the hype, there's definitely some palettes that I could still count, and the list goes on. I would say there's further up the list is the Huda Beauty Retrograde palette. I really did not think this was worth the hype. I've said it before in my previous videos, these glitters cause a lot of fallout, and every time I put that on my eye, it's like Fallout City, and so I did not like the Retrograde. I know some people loved it, but for me, these two were not worth the hype. And if I had to choose one particular palette that's not worth the hype, I would actually go with the latest Huda pastels. The green ones was definitely not worth the hype. I thought maybe because the lilac one had some good reviews, that one would be worth it, but unfortunately that one was also not worth the hype either, and kind of a disappointment, to be honest. So favorite palette from a favorite brand. So my favorite brand, as you guys know by now, it's definitely got to be Pat McGrath. So if I had to choose from all of my Pat McGrath palettes, which I think by now I'm starting to own quite a few of them, I would say I would go with the Mothership, the Subliminal Pat McGrath 1 palette. I know in my previous ranking videos I said the Divine Rose, and I think I can have a new favorite every time, but right now my favorite is definitely the first one, and I still haven't got the latest one shipped to me yet, so I think that one is the best one, because I'm into blues right now and purples, and I really like that one, and I feel like I can get a lot of different looks out of, you know, and a lot of people have seemed to have forgotten about this palette, but I think I cherish it a lot. I still want to rank my favorite one of the Natasha Denona's, not just the one that I made together, but actually right now I would say one of my favorite Natasha Denona palettes is the Retro palette, and I find that to be a very nice everyday palette as well, and definitely worth the hype as well. So, you know, I can't make up my mind between Pat McGrath and Natasha Denona. This palette is definitely worth so much. And next question is, most used palette in your collection. So I have barely used a lot of palettes because I have a lot, but the most used palette is probably the one that arrived broken, and I was kind of forced to use it, otherwise it would go all over the place. And so that was one of the Huda Minis. I can't remember what this was called. It was one from her Emerald Obsessions collection, or Electric Obsessions. And that one was definitely the most used palette. Unfortunately, I haven't hit pan. Most luxurious packaging in your collection. So quite a few palettes have good packaging, like the Pat McGrath, but I want to go out of my range here today and talk about a palette that was probably released earlier around January in 2020, and I didn't get to talk about it as much because, you know, everything's been going on this year. But the most luxurious packaging, it would probably go to the Terry by Paris, or Terribly by Paris. This packaging is just amazing. I am so interested in this, and I love that how etched the box is. And once you actually get to open it up, you will see a beautiful detail in there with every shade being etched. I think it's with like laser or something, and just the reflection. I just don't even want to use it. I've had it since January and I don't want to use it because it's just, the packaging is just so amazing. It's like a collector's item, and I probably should use it at some point. I wish I had gotten another one for a giveaway. But yeah, that's the most luxurious packaging, and the least luxurious packaging in my collection. You know, there's quite a few, but when I think least luxurious, I think of cardboard box, but good palette. And so when I think of a cardboard packaging, I'm definitely going to go with an Ulta palette for that. And this one was just released a couple months ago. It was the Black Widow palette, and I think it was like $20 or $15 with their coupon. This is the least luxurious, and I think it didn't do justice for the movie as far as the packaging, but the actual quality of the shadows are pretty good for an Ulta palette. So that's why I would think it's the least luxurious packaging compared to, for example, something like the Terry by Paris. So yeah, that's my least luxurious palette. My first luxury palette, I think it was like back in 2016. There was like some Dior and Chanel and Lancome palettes that I was really interested in. And probably the first purchase I made for a luxury palette was the Dior palette. I really liked the color combination in this one with the reds, pinks, and golds. And I'd say, yeah, that was one of my first luxury brand purchases for an eyeshadow palette. I did also have a Lancome one. I don't know what happened to it. And so yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments below, what did you think? Do you agree? Do you not agree? Do you think we should have had different choices? And you know, as always, let me know in your comments below what you thought, and make sure that you're subscribed to be entered into monthly giveaways, and the details are linked below. And as always, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys again next time. Thank you.